Retractable. When we started talking about building this airplane, we felt that we wanted something different. And amphibious capability is something that none of the other ultralights did. So we started out thinking right from the start that we had to have a hole-type fuselage. We needed solid wing structures. We needed a canard in the front to keep it out of the spray water. We needed very quick and responsive controls. We needed a rear engine to keep the wind and the noise out away from the pilot. And we needed a comfortable type airplane. In other words, we wanted an airplane that would fly like an airplane and not like a hang glider.
Way to look at.
This fits a little slot in the wing, so that as soon as you put the wing on, it automatically hooks up the spoiler. There's no way to hook it up wrong. This is the mating paddle that goes to it, so the two hook together. This is what operates the spoiler in the wing. The gear right here is all made of fiberglass. This is a special material we buy from the 3M company called Scotchply. You can see it flexing right there. My feet are out in front of me, feet are on the rudder pedals. You can see in the rear, that's how we control our yaw. It's very responsive. You know, you can handle a crosswind up to about 30 miles an hour. Once you're in flight, you look out at the canard, it's a tremendous horizontal reference. For example, in level flight at 50 miles an hour, the horizon sets about 6 inches above the top of the canard. So you can see really well right out in front of you. It tips up at an angle to where there's almost no vision blocked, only about a 6-inch wide strip across there. The windshield comes up, deflects the wind up over my head, which will completely enclose the pilot. Of course, we're going to have a bubble canopy option and really make it great for the cold weather and flying in the winter when you're flying in the water and stuff. I would expect it. Nearly any of the XTCs that are put together to have about a 14-to-1 glide ratio. A lot of guys say, what happens when the motor quits? The airplane becomes quite a glider. In fact, of all the ultralights that I've flown, I don't think any of them can claim this kind of a glide ratio. In water, normal takeoff, it's kind of like a motorboat. You add the power, the nose tries to come up. So what do? You push forward on the stick to hold the nose down and get it on the step. Once on the step, an aft movement with a stick brings the nose up and you're flying. Every piece of skin material on the entire aircraft is molded. This is all formed in female molds. In fact, the fuselage even comes in two parts. It's a top and a bottom section, and it glues together right on the spray rail. It leaves a very slick exterior surface. All of the parts already come in a natural fiberglass color, but finished smooth, so all you have to do is sand it with a 400 sandpaper and shoot your paint on it. The outer wing panel comes already molded, the wing spar is in it, and the attached fittings are also in it. The rudders, the vertical stabilizers, come molded, you just got to glue them on. Right in the center of the cockpit is the T-handle for the nose gear retraction. It is separate from the main landing gear because we felt that in the water, you need the nose gear and the up position to act when it folds up, it's kind of out in front, so it acts as a rubber bumper. If you crash into a dock or something like that, you have a bumper in front. But we thought that the main gear ought to be down for very slow and tight maneuvering in the water, like around a boat dock, et cetera. With the main gear down, it makes a lot of drag, and it makes the airplane move real slowly in the water, even at idle. With the main gear up, it'll still go as much as 5 miles an hour in the water. So we leave the main gear down when we're maneuvering in tight quarters. Also, at your arm's length, we've got the choke lever over here it's a manual choke for the engine. And your left hand is the throttle, and the right hand over here is the control stick. The blue button on top is a push-to-talk button. It controls the radio. Little radio right here fits in your pocket, the earpiece, and the boom microphone's in the helmet. So all we do is plug that little plug right into the radio, and when we want to talk, we just push the button. The controls are very conventional. It's a three-axis control system. Pushing and pulling on the stick moves the canard in front. This controls your pitch axis. Moving left and right controls the spoilers. We use spoilers on the airplane instead of ailerons for several reasons. First one being it's a lot easier to hook up. Second reason is that on a canard you don't want the main wing ever to be in a stalled condition, and you can get an increased angle of attack with a dropped aileron. So we just lower the high wing rather than trying to raise the low wing. Another thing, of course, is that an aileron that would drop down, of course, could stand a chance on dragging in the water. At your feet, you have the standard rudder pedals. We have the dual rudders. They're also hooked to the steerable nose wheel, so ground handling is really simple. It controls your individual rear heel brakes to make quick stops on land. The engine is built in Italy, called a KFM. It's built by the Comet Flying Motor Company. These folks have been building racing go-kart engines for over 30 years now. It's a 25 horsepower, just under 300 cc engine. With the electric starter, it has a 10 amp alternator. Comes complete with a tuned exhaust. Belt reduction units all built right into it. You get all of this at a reasonable cost.
Tell me about something. Are you going to trust your life to this? You're going to fly?
You better believe it. This airplane is way overbuilt. We've actually load tested the airplane to 4 G's, which is actually 4 times the weight of gravity, and with no structural damage at all. In other words, we know it'll do that without any problem at all. And so we really feel that the airplane is quite strong.
It's designed to be assembled from a kit and to take off from land or lake. They hope it will be the perfect sports plane for the amateur pilot who won't even need a license to fly it.